There are two paired paraganglia within the larynx, superior and inferior, from which the laryngeal paraganglioma arises. The superior paraganglia is located in the false cord just lateral to the quadrangular membrane in close proximity to the superior laryngeal vessels and nerve. The inferior paraganglia is slightly larger and more variable in location in adult. It is usually located between the cricoid cartilage and first tracheal ring and is often in close proximity to recurrent laryngeal nerve and artery. The majority of laryngeal paraganglioma, about 80%, originate from the superior paraganglia. Laryngeal paragangliomas are usually not familial and are associated with additional paragangliomas in about 3% of cases. There is 3% rate of malignancy and 3% rate of catecholamine secreting tumors. Laryngeal paragangliomas are 3 times more common in females than the male, and they are slightly right-sided more common than the left-sided. The most common presenting symptom is hoarseness of voice, about 70% of cases, followed by dysphagia, then dyspnea, and stridor present only 20% of the cases. Due to airway obstruction, infraglottic laryngeal paragangliomas commonly present sooner than the supraglottic laryngeal paragangliomas. Vocal cord palsy is not commonly noted in paragangliomas. On laryngoscopy, a red or blue submucosal mass is usually appreciated. Biopsy of any submucosal laryngeal mass should not be performed without prior imaging, since paraganglioma can bleed profusely. So imaging is necessary before doing biopsy. On CCT, typically show a highly vascular, hyperintense lesion within the larynx, and you can make the presumptive diagnosis by CT scan. Octreotide scanning or angiography can also be performed if needed. Blood supply to the tumor is usually from the laryngeal branch of the superior thyroid artery, though bilateral blood supply has been reported. Preoperative embolization is technically difficult and its role is unclear due to paucity of the cases. Since these laryngeal paragangliomas do not typically shrink with the radiation, so radiotherapy is not recommended. Conservative laryngeal excision is the modality of choice for the laryngeal paragangliomas. Smaller tumor can be removed endoscopically, although this can prove to be difficult secondary to bleeding. Larger tumor can be removed with an open supraglottic laryngectomy. Due to location, a total laryngectomy is sometimes necessary for infraglottic paragangliomas. Initial control of superior thyroid vessel can decrease intraoperative bleeding. Recurrence rate can be higher than about 17% due to inadequate excision.